Work on that steering.
Well, Richie here, my fellow Drifting MX. I'm down at the college today with the WL Toys 124019 with its brushless 6900 kV Castle conversion. Should you carry on watching this video? Oh, I think so. Awesome is not the word for this car. So, it's round two of my brushless conversion for the WL Toys 124019 Castle 6900 kb motor on board, Genzase 2200 milliamp lipo, and my Power Hobby GNSS speed meter all ready to see how we get on. Seems to have a bit more grip these days, fingers crossed, than it did yesterday when we were in the rain. Could still be a bit of a handful though. See if I can get on the power early on. Oh yeah. Oh, and Richie forgets he still hasn't adjusted the brakes. Oh.
In the distance there, a brake very hard just clipped the wall.
That was lucky. I'd need to adjust the brakes. That could have been absolutely catastrophic. Man, that thing was going like a missile.
Well, I would just say, in this video, you're going to see me show you two GPS speed readings. The first one is quite quick. The second one, oh, mama.
Oh, Richie, what have you created? Oh, my God. The acceleration is, it's up there with that Richie phrase, plain bonkers. Man, I'm going to have to get somewhere bigger. This is not going to peak out on here. This has got 100 in it. I'm thinking this has got 100 in it in this spec. Even with the stock gearing, that thing is like an absolute bleeping missile.
Just remember, guys, if you like what you see today, don't forget to subscribe.
Work on that steering. My God.
Literally, this is one of the fastest things I think I have driven in, well, God knows how long. Rich, you have built an absolute missile. But that braking, got to adjust the braking. That was quick, and it's got more in it. It's got more. I'm running out of room. I'm braking halfway between these two pillars.
Twelve satellites on it.
It should be picking this up better. Let's get on that power early as we can.
Oh man! First time it's lifted like that.
Sometimes with speed runs, luck does come into it.
Just verging on absolute insanity. It is far and away the quickest accelerating thing that I think I've possibly ever built. Come on, give me a good reading. 78 miles an hour on there.
Whoa, Richie, whoa, moment. 78 miles an hour? Trust me, this thing's gonna go far faster than that in a second.
Now I have a confession to make. The first few runs I did on it, I think it was running a little bit quicker, but the GPS played up and wasn't working again. 78, I think it's got 80 in it today. Let's see. When you're that far away from it, you can barely tell which way around it is. You know it's going to be coming towards you fairly quick. Oh man, those brakes definitely need adjusting. It's so close, it's untrue. I think it will go faster. I'm literally probably leaving it as late a brake as I can by this pillar here, and that's probably 500 feet down there. Come on, over 80. 99 miles an hour! It's an empty park. I can dance around and scream. Right. Oh, Richard, calm down. Calm down, Richie boy. Calm down. 3S. This has got the stock gearing on it. It hasn't peaked out. I'm braking by this pillar just to make the corner. This is going to go over 100 with the stock gearing. I'm sorry. I wish I had another camera. Well, what can I say, people? I thought Richie had made some mentally fast cars before. This thing takes it to a whole nother level. Man, hit that thumbs up button because you know this makes sense. Anyway, I thought I built some mentally fast cars before. This thing takes it to a completely different level. Literally, I'm braking here and the thing is still accelerating. This is going to do over 100 with the stock gearing. Just blown away by that. The increase in the power by holding the throttle on that little bit longer. All the power is with a 6900 kV motor is at the top end. So that first run on 78, it was only just getting in to the power band. And when I kept it down at the top end, getting another 21 miles an hour out of it, because it just was like a scalded cat at that top end. Anyway, I've got a spot in mind to do a top speed run with this car. And I think that figure may have a one in it next time. Anyway, if you don't want to miss that, don't forget to like, share and subscribe and give this the thumbs up.
So is that the most insane RC car build that Richie has built to date? Quite possibly so. The acceleration when it hooks up and you give it full throttle is just simply surreal. If you look at the packaging on that car, that is what I'm really pleased at on there. Why is that, Richie? Well, we've got the stock body on there. It's not buckling up or anything like that. And I'm really pleased with it because everything is packaged so nicely inside the car. We have a Castle Sidewinder 4 ESC mated to a Castle 6900 kV motor. Battery? Well, that's a 2,200 milliamp one from Gen's Ace, 50C rating, and that powered that to a smidgen under 100, and the car hadn't peaked out, was running out of room. Absolutely outstanding. I'll put a link to everything I fit to this car, even the tyres, on the video. And I would also point out, in this video, the car was running with the stock gearing. It has the existing plastic spur on board. All I've done is fit a new metal pinion, but it's exactly the same size as the stock one on the car, which also happens to be metal, by the way. Now the car has no added weight to it, no extra wings, canards, anything like that at all, but I'm very, very pleased with it. The only modification I've really done to the car, other than the electrics, is at the front, where I've effectively put in two droop screws, which has lowered the front of the car down, so it runs at an angle like that, so we're getting the airflow pushing the front of the car down, rather than getting underneath it and flipping it up, although we did have one near miss in that video. Anyway, undoubtedly this thing will be going over 100 miles an hour on its next time out. You know what to do if you don't want to miss that. Well, thumbs up if you like this video, guys. Post any comments you might have in the comment section below the video and hit the circle below to subscribe. And if you do hit the circle, don't forget to hit the bell.